Yes. And if everyone wants to come, I know the sun's over there, but if you can get a little closer, I don't bite much, but yeah, come a little closer, come a little closer. We have chairs for anybody who wants to sit, but yes, they are in the sun.
Recording and broadcasting, yeah.
Fantastic. Thank you all for being here today. My name is Gary Saperstein from Out in the Vineyard.
Recording? Yeah.
And I am thrilled to be here today. Looking out, I think we have, I mean, by my count, it looks like about 34 people, wouldn't you say? Just about? Just my estimate. But that's all I'm going to say about that. But welcome, everybody. Welcome. This is amazing. Our community is amazing. All of it. It's a beautiful, beautiful community and a beautiful, amazing place that we live here in Sonoma Valley. So thank you. And thank you to our Sonoma City. We could not do this without them. And our city council, who Mayor John Gurney is here, Councilwoman Ron Wellander is here, Councilwoman Patricia Farhar Rivas is here, Councilwoman Sandra Lowe is here. It's John, I don't think, not here, but that's okay. I can tell you this, I've had many conversations over the course of the past months with almost each city council member, and I can tell you that they have our back. They want to support our community, they believe in diversity and inclusion and acceptance and equality, and they want that here in Sonoma Valley. And also, there are so many amazing people and organizations here in Sonoma. I do want to take a moment just to mention a few people. First of all, I want to also thank our city manager, David Gouin, who's standing over there. Also, totally responsible and helped every step of the way in making today happen. And in case anybody hasn't noticed, we this year have rainbow crosswalks entering and exiting our horseshoe over here, which thank you to our city council for that, and especially a huge shout out to Lisa Jansen, the events manager for the city, who we had so many conversations about it, and she cared so much to getting it right and making it right for our community. So thank you, Lisa. I know you're here somewhere, but also here, we have a huge community. And we have a community of supporters out here, like our Sonoma Valley trustees, Celeste Winders, who could not be here today. She couldn't be here today, unfortunately. But I want to tell you what Celeste is working on right now, because it's really important, it's vital. She is working on codifying an actual policy that ensures protection for all LGBTQIA students here in Sonoma Valley. Yes, an actual policy. She wants kids to be made to feel safer in their schools, and as she told me, she wants them to feel more loved than they do now. So that is something huge. I want to also thank our Sonoma Community Center, who, if you go by that beautiful, iconic building right now, has two beautiful banners, pride banners, hanging down from the very top of the building to the bottom. They have also partnered with Positive Images, an amazing organization in Sonoma County that supports LGBTQ youth, and they now have a queer arts program at the community center. We now have an organization like Wake Up Sonoma that has, yeah, you know, that has opened many people's eyes to many things that are going on in our community. But they also have a mission, and their mission is to promote transparency, diversity, equity, and inclusion in Sonoma. And they have all free Pride merch at a table out there, so if you have, get your Pride merch from courtesy of Wake Up Sonoma and the Horizons Foundation as well. And then we also have our own Sonoma Gaydar group, which is a group, yes, the group that, you know, we organize, get together, wherever it may be, pop-ups, bars, restaurants. But it's great to bring community together, and we get to do that here in Sonoma Valley. Yeah. I'm also very proud of my company out in the vineyard that has really helped open, thank you, but has really helped open the wine industry to our community. And I'm really thrilled for that. They have helped, along with so many people and supporters, help raise almost $700,000 for LGBTQ nonprofits in Sonoma County. Shout out also, if you have not been to the Sonoma Valley Pride website, yes, we do have one. Matt Long is somewhere out there. Matthew Long designed a beautiful website. Thank you, Matthew. And if you haven't been to it, SonomaValleyPride.com. This is what we need more of in this community. We need to let people know far and wide that Sonoma is a welcoming community. And we believe in equality for all and nothing less. So Pride Month is here, and we are here for it. I'm here for it, we are here for it, to not only recognize and to celebrate it, but to honor it. To honor it, to know that all who came before us, whose shoulders we stand on. And I wish I could stand here and say that the climate is better than it was last year at this time, but we all know that it is not. There are still so many anti-LGBTQ bills that are being tried, that people are trying to pass all around the country. We are at a time when extremists are attempting to paint the LGBT community as a threat to others, especially children and families and our trans community, and we cannot let that happen. I look out here today and think about all the joy and love that is shared amongst us. And I know that our community can and will always and can blaze a trail of joy, because that's what we do when we are faced with adversity. We do it every single time. And when I mean that, I mean love for all in our community. Our lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgenders are beautiful. We are unstoppable. And it takes one voice to make a difference, and the voice of many to really create that change. And we need our voices to be heard this year. It is an election year. And what I want to see is a rainbow wave across this country that says, that makes a statement that's going to ensure our future and the future generations for our community. Starting today, yes. And I know that our love will always win, and that is what we celebrate here today. Let us celebrate love and kindness and generosity. That is our guiding force, because love will always win every time. So happy Pride, everybody. Thank you for being here. We have esteemed speakers with us today, and I'd like to introduce to you the superintendent of Sonoma Valley Unified School District here, Dr. Jeanette Rodriguez-Chin, who is actually just now a year on the job. So you can tell us what's happening in our school systems and everything you have experienced in your first year here.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for having me here this afternoon. You actually shared a little bit about what we're doing in the district, but I just want to let people know there's a lot of things that we're planning to do next year as a result of something that we learned this year, and I want to share with you what it is that we did. We've been taking lots of time and opportunities to meet with our students directly. What we are doing is we're meeting with students in what we're calling listening circles and asking them questions about their experiences in school. We're asking them, what makes you feel safe? What are you happy about? And what are the things that you'd like to see be done differently so that you have a better learning experience? And in these listening circles, we're hearing from our LGBTQIA students that they don't necessarily always feel safe, welcomed, and included. And so the more that we hear from our students, we want to respond to that, and we want to make sure that everyone all students, including our LGBTQIA students, feel like they belong, like they are always welcomed. And so next year, we have lots of things in store so that our students have the opportunity to walk into school and feel like they're loved, they're cared for, and they're not worried about having somebody say something to them or feel harassed. And so I'm just gonna share a little bit about what we're going to be doing. You're right, we're working on a equity LGBTQIA DEI board policy. Actually, we introduced it last month at our board meeting. This coming Thursday, we're going to be having our meeting where our trustees will be looking at that for approval. And in that policy, we talk about how we want to provide opportunities for our students to have clubs, to have the teachers and the staff be able to use the pronouns that students want to be used and known as. We are also going to be training all of our staff members on implicit bias, and we're going to be talking to them about all of the different definitions of LGBTQIA. I don't know that a lot of our staff has had very formalized training around that, so that's what we're going to be doing next year, starting with our principals in August. The other thing that I wanted to let everyone know is that we also, on top of the listening circles, we also ask our students to give us information about how they feel in what we call a youth truth survey. It's a survey that we give out every spring. And what we do there is we disaggregate the data based on not just race, ethnicity, socioeconomic status, but also gender. And what we're finding is that a lot of our LGBTQIA students, again, are feeling like they are ostracized, not just in school, but outside of school. And we all know that our suicide rate amongst our LGBTQIA youngsters is extremely high compared to other students. And we don't want to see anyone feel like they have to go to that extreme because you're not cared for. So Sonoma Valley Unified is a place where we want to ensure that our kids feel loved and cared for. There's a couple quotes I want to read. I was looking at this earlier today and wondering, like, what do I want to say? And I know that I wanted to talk a little bit about what we're doing at the district, but I want to also say why. Why are we doing this? I talked about the fact that we want our students to feel loved, but I also feel like the more that we open up our students' minds and hearts, the more likely they are to be successful and thrive in our society, because we're living with human beings, right? We're all human, and we have to be able to be open-minded and open-hearted. So I'm going to be reading a quote from Harvey Milk, and what he said was, "All young people, regardless of their sexual orientation or identity, deserve a safe and supportive environment in which to achieve their full potential." And that's what we want for our students. We want them to achieve their full potential. And I have another quote from Adam Grant, and this is what he says. "It's hard to keep an open mind if you don't have an open heart. You don't have to agree with what people think to learn from how they think. You don't have to share their identity to be curious about what shaped it. Treating people with civility is a prerequisite for discovery." Thank you.
Beautiful words, beautiful words. Thank you. And now, please, our mayor of Sonoma, Mayor John Gurney.
Well, thank you very much for being here. It's quite the honor. The first question I have is, what size shoe do you wear, Gary? I want those. Watch out, they'll probably show up at my house. Anyway, you know, it's so interesting to me that we have to have these kinds of events, and because everybody should feel connected. Everybody should feel wanted. Everybody should feel like they belong. And unfortunately, there are still situations that prevent that from happening. And so what I want to talk about is the City Council, City of Sonoma, and how important each and every one of you are to the fabric of this community. And there should be great appreciation for everything that you bring to the table, your life experiences, your orientations, and it's so important to be equitable, inclusive, transparent, and Gary probably said one of the most important words, loved, and we should all feel that way. And so my message is we should feel loved. And in the words of Ringo Starr, peace and love should be our cornerstone in terms of living in a community together. And so the City of Sonoma, on behalf of the council members, we honor you today, but it would be a lot more fun if we just party. But I think that's going to happen anyway. And so thank you for coming out. Thank you for supporting the community. And in return, the City Council will continue to hold the values near and dear as we look at every aspect of the work that we do. And so please, please, please know that you are supported in this community, and we are honored to celebrate with you today.
Yes, we do know how to party. That is one thing. We definitely know how to do that. And we will do that. And now, please, I know our sheriff is here, Brandon Cutting, who spoke with us last year and had really beautiful words to say. And so we wanted you to come back again.
All right. I'm going to open this up with saying something that on June 28th, 1970, was definitely not heard from somebody wearing a uniform similar to this, not like this, but similar. Good evening, beautiful people. That is such a different language than was spoken in that day. Yet, law enforcement has come an incredible distance in how we relate to the communities that we serve. You are one of our communities that we serve. We understand that, and actually, I'll take it back a step. A few months ago, at a city council meeting, Mr. the esteemed Gary was there and spoke about how he feels in this community and how safe he feels, yet he always has a concern of a violent crime coming to him just because of who he loves. That, to me, is a very effective speech he gave, because I heard it, and I feel like Sonoma is an incredibly safe place. If you were to judge Sonoma by statistics, there is no hate crimes that happen in Sonoma. But if you judge it based on the way each of you feel concern or even apprehension about something happening, then it might not be as safe of a place, and that's where we, law enforcement, need to do better. And so what I would ask you, each of you, is if something happens, if something makes you feel uncomfortable, if you feel like a situation is not right, let us know. We want to know. If we don't hear from you, we don't know about it. On that side, we understand there are parts of the LGBTQ, the transgender specifically portion of the community, that law enforcement has a very difficult time being able to communicate with, and we are trying to do better. There is a lot of well-documented issues that we may not speak the same language, and we could create apprehensions in the dialogue between the two of us. Please, if you're transgender, please communicate with us. Let us know. Teach us how to communicate better with you. We are working on it as law enforcement as a whole. I really want to understand. I want you to understand that this community is the safest place I have been in Sonoma County. And your rights and who you love is your right. And intolerance is not going to be handled well by anybody. And so please let us know when things are going on. And on that, I wish I could arrest intolerance away. I wish I could just get rid of it altogether. And the best way I know how, I can't. It's not a law yet. Call your congressman, call your state representatives, and let's make it one. I really appreciate it. I hope everybody has a great time. Yes, yes, thank you for that. No intolerance. Yeah. And now I'd like to bring to the microphone here, everyone knows her, always wonderful, always has those amazing things to say, Reverend Karen Reichert is here. Yeah. Bum ba da, bum ba da.
Queerly beloved, we are gathered here today to say loudly and clearly that who we are matters. The way we live, the choices we make in this world matter. You matter. Precious humans, you matter. You are not a problem to be solved. You have gifts that are unique to who you are, and the world needs those gifts. You are wiser and stronger and more creative than you have been led to believe. You are enough. I want you to turn to somebody next to you and say, you are fabulous.
You are fabulous.
Yes. Yes, you are fabulous. You are fabulous. And as we immerse ourselves in the vibrant colors and joyful celebrations of Pride Month, it is also important that we pause and remember the struggles that our community has faced. You see, COVID wasn't our first pandemic, was it, friends? So we're going to take a moment to call out the names of those we lost to the AIDS pandemic, and those still living with AIDS, those who have been brutally murdered by the hands of homophobic and transphobic individuals. And finally, the names of those who have found it, as our superintendent said, who have found it too painful to stay on this planet because they were not accepted for who they were. So I'm going to take my hand and move it this way, and I invite you to call out the names. Call out the names. Beloved spirits, we will never forget you. And now to the flags, which today have grown to include the progress flag and the trans flag, but I thought it was yes. Yes. A yes. There it is. There it is. The rainbow flag was created in 1978 by artist and designer, Vietnam veteran, and then former drag queen, Gilbert Baker. He was commissioned to create the flag by another gay icon who's been mentioned here this evening, Harvey Milk, for the San Francisco's annual Pride Parade. Baker had been inspired by the celebrations marking America's bicentennial in 1976, noting that the constant display of stars and stripes made him realize the cultural need for a similar rallying sign for the gay community. As a struggling drag performer, who was accustomed to creating his own garments, he was well equipped to sew the soon-to-be iconic symbol. With the help of close to 30 volunteers working in the attic of the Gay Community Center in San Francisco, never doubt the importance of a community center, Baker constructed the first draft of the now world-renowned rainbow flag. It was first showcased at the San Francisco Gay Freedom Day Parade on June 25th, 1968. We celebrate all of the flag's rightful places here in the center of our city square this day in Sonoma. Yeah. Beloved, let us continue to educate ourselves, advocate for equality, and use the power of pride to amplify the voices of those who are fighting for acceptance and love in all its forms. Happy Pride.
Yes, thank you, Reverend. And look at those pride flags proudly displayed above our city hall. This next person I'm going to introduce you to, I actually met, God, about a decade ago or so, I think it was. And she was a singer, and a gorgeous singer, absolutely beautiful. But since then, she's gone on to become an activist for not only the transgender community, but our entire community. She was recently also just named as the, from Mayor London Breed, to lead the San Francisco Office of Transgender Initiatives. And we are so thrilled, I'm personally so thrilled, to be able to introduce to you all Honey Mahogany.
Let's give it up one more time for Gary Saperstein, who is just such an incredible person. And yes, we did meet over a decade ago, and it's been a decade of incredible events and activism on your part. So thank you for your leadership. Thank you, Mayor Ding. Thank you especially to Councilwoman Lowe, who invited me here today. So thank you for inviting me all the way here to Sonoma County. My name is Honey Mahogany. I am, yes indeed, from San Francisco, born and raised. But I have a confession. I have a deep love for Sonoma County. I mean, I was stuck in traffic for about an hour and a half today, and I couldn't even be mad because it was so, so beautiful driving over here. My partner actually is from not too far away. He grew up in Santa Rosa. So we definitely have it in our minds to come back at some point and maybe move to Sonoma County. And let me tell you that seeing all of you here today just affirms for me what a wonderful and amazing, magical, accepting, beautiful place that Sonoma County and Sonoma City is. So thank you so much for all of you being here today. A little bit about me. I grew up, as I said, in San Francisco. My parents were actually refugees, and believe it or not, they were political refugees. My father lost his Ethiopian citizenship when he was studying abroad as a doctor. He was organizing with other students against a dictatorship that had taken over Ethiopia at that time. The government then revoked his citizenship, left him without a visa, and he was forced to come here to the Bay Area as a refugee. My mother followed. Me and my brother were born, and we grew up here in San Francisco. I say that to say that my parents really believed in the American dream, that, you know, once you come to a place like America where we have freedom, you can be whomever you want to be, and that this dream was for everyone. Now, I think that that dream has been tested time and again, but it comes to people like us, people who are here today, to keep fighting for that dream, because we as Americans have been through a lot, and yes, we're going through a specifically tough time as the LGBTQ community, as people of color, as trans people, as women, as people who are working class. All of these communities right now feel like they are under attack and struggling, but there is hope. This country was founded on hope, on bringing people together, on diversity, on hard work and organizing, meaning that one day we will absolutely win. I want to give a shout out to the Church Ladies for Gay Rights. Reverend, I don't know if you brought them here today, but it is so inspiring to me because I grew up in the Catholic Church. You know, I like to call myself a recovering Catholic, but I really believe that the Catholic Church and my 13 years of Catholic school, including kindergarten, is what led me to pursue activism. Because I think, because I disagreed with so many parts, well, a few parts, including, you know, being trans, being pro-choice, you know, all of these things were really in conflict, I think, with the teachings of the church. But the things that I really clung to were being of service, being the change you want to see in the world, being a person for others. And that's what led me to really pursue activism, to start working within the LGBTQ community. My first full-time job was working at Larkin Street Youth Services, which is a homeless and at-risk youth organization. But I specifically was working as the LGBTQ advisor. So I worked with LGBTQ communities there. I also worked as the first full-time employee of the Rainbow Community Center in Contra Costa County, helping to build their youth program, helping to set up their mental health program. And it was through that work that I realized that, yes, being a social worker, doing all of these things on the ground was really fulfilling, but something that was really preventing me from being able to do my job was the fact that a lot of the money that we needed to do our jobs was tied up in city and county grants and statewide grants, and those grants dictated the ways in which we could do the work. That's what got me involved in advocacy, in, you know, joining the Harvey Milk Democratic Club in San Francisco, becoming the president of that club, eventually getting appointed to the San Francisco Democratic Party, then becoming elected to the San Francisco Democratic Party and serving as chair, becoming the first trans person to ever be elected chair of any Democratic County Central Committee in the country. And I went on from there to work in the local legislature. I became a legislative aide and then chief of staff to then Supervisor Matt Haney, who is now a state assembly member. I became his district director at that level. But I say this because that change that I wanted to see, that change that I was fighting for, it couldn't have happened unless I took it upon myself to really engage in local politics, to really get involved, to talk to my neighbors and friends, to organize, to bring people together to create that change, because you can't just leave it up to somebody else, especially right now in this time when our community is so under attack. Now is the time to stand up and make your voice heard and be a part of positive change. Have those tough conversations with your families and loved ones. Have those tough conversations with your neighbors. Fly that pride flag and send the message that we will not tolerate intolerance. I will say, though things have been hard over the last few years, last year we saw over 700 anti-LGBTQ laws introduced in legislatures across the state. This year we've already seen over 500. I have seen the way in which our community has risen to the occasion. We have equality chapters across the country rising up to fight back against this legislation, suing these local and state governments. Southern Equality is doing amazing work all throughout the South. We just heard that in Florida, many of DeSantis's anti-LGBTQ laws, including the Don't Say Gay law, has been successfully undermined. I think it was something like 22 of the 23 provisions have been successfully fought back and settled in court. So even though things are scary right now, I think we're winning. And I see that every day when I look at all of the youth who stand up and fight back and make their voices heard, because guess what? They've grown up in a time where they are used to enjoying their rights and they don't want to go back. They absolutely do not want to go back, and they're mad at us that they have to deal with this, that they have to be the ones going to marches and speaking at school board meetings. And I want to appreciate the speaker who talked about what is happening here in the Sonoma County District to fight back against discrimination and intolerance and the depression that is affecting our kids, because they see what's going on. Even here in California, our school boards are under attack. We've seen what happened in Temecula. We've seen what happened in counties across school districts across the state. Luckily, we do have a superintendent who is fighting back. We do have parents who are organizing and pushing back, recalling, you know, homophobic and transphobic school board members who are not interested in our kids being successful, having an education, or being healthy, but are in there with an agenda to take our countries backwards in terms of civil rights. So we have work to do. I want to thank all of you for continuing to do it, but I want to also celebrate the fact that we are on the right track. We are winning. We have got it. We're gonna get there. And finally, this is Pride season. It's a time to remember all of the amazing work that we've done to celebrate who we are as a community and to let our Pride flag fly in the breeze and stand strong. So thank you, all of you here who are here to celebrate Sonoma Pride. It is an honor to be here from the City and County of San Francisco. Congratulations and happy Pride.
Yes, those are the words we need. Yes, it is Pride Month, and we're going to celebrate, even though we know that there's a lot of work to be done. But let me tell you what we're going to do now. We're going to take a walk. We're going to take a walk around the plaza. Yes, raise your flags. If you have a sign, take a sign. There's plenty of stuff on the Wake Up Sonoma table. What I want us to do is walk down to the end of the horseshoe. Over here, the entrance, so that we can all stop, take a look at the rainbow crosswalk. Robbie's gonna maybe try and take a picture if she's still here, I can't remember. And then we're gonna go around the square this way, and then we can end up with, we're gonna have a reception at Sunflower Caffé. Thank you, Sunflower Caffé, with wines by Corner 103 and Passaggio Wines. Thank you, Cindy Costco. And also sponsored by the city, our City of Sonoma, and by Spark. Thank you, Spark, as well. So everyone, let's follow, I guess you'll follow me.